In this video, I'm going to be walking you through the process of taking your flow out of test mode and fully launching it to all of your work items. I'll be covering how to use flow status to understand its health, looking at metrics to see how your flows are performing, and how to duplicate your flows and edit them as your workflow grows and changes. In this example, I have a one-way flow from Trello to Airtable. It's currently in what we call test mode, which basically just means only new Trello cards and Airtable records are syncing. We can tell which flows are in test mode as they have the only new task tag on the front. We've already tested our flow with some new test cards and records, and everything is working as expected. So we can now take our flow out of test mode to roll this out to all historical items in our board and table. On the left here, we have Trello. And on the right is Airtable. Only cards here in Trello with the purple website label should sync into Airtable. But because the flow is in test mode, only these three new test cards here have synced into Airtable, allowing me to have a play around without messing up all these cards here the team are working on. When I turn off test mode, Unito will sync all the historical cards with the website label. You can turn off test mode in our flow list here, or you can edit the flow to remove the rule to only sync new cards and records as shown here. After confirming this, you'll see the status change to let you know Unito is syncing. What's happening now is Unito is going through and doing a retroactive sync. So we're scanning through all items in both Trello and Airtable, looking for the ones that need to sync. If you have a lot of items on either side, like a lot of Trello cards or a lot of Airtable records, Unito may take a while to complete the full import. So it's best to leave Unito to do its thing and check back later in the day. If we scroll down to the activity screen here, we'll be able to see all the operations Unito is processing. If you need to see more detail or older logs, you can open the activity stream from here. Let's have a look back in Trello and Airtable to see how things are looking. We should see a few more records in the new request column in Airtable, and Trello should look about the same. Great, this is looking good. I can see all the historical Trello cards with the website label have synced into Airtable here. When the sync is complete, we'll see the status change to either healthy, letting us know that everything synced over successfully. If the flow is syncing fine, but there is something that needs fixing, the status will change to review. And if something that is preventing the flow from syncing, the status will change to unable to sync. If anything needs fixing, you'll see instructions on how to resolve the issue from your edit screen here. If you need any help, our friendly team is just a chat bubble away in the bottom right-hand corner here. Once Unito starts syncing, you'll be able to track all your flows metrics using Workspace Analytics. Here we can see an estimate on how many hours we've saved over the past month. This is based on the amount of time saved manually copying and pasting information. We can track how many changes have synced per day and how many users are actively involved in our flows. Now that we have one flow working nicely, you might want to create more flows across other boards and projects. Unito offers a duplicate flow feature to help you save a bit of time when setting everything up. A use case for duplicating a flow is if you have one main board or project that needs to connect to many other boards and projects. In this example here, I have one main master repository in GitHub that I need to sync with many different Rike projects. The settings for each flow will be very similar, so using the duplicate flow feature will make things a bit easier. The idea is to have multiple flows where the master stays the same on the left, so the GitHub repository will remain the same. Each flow, though, will have a different Rike project on the right-hand side. I have one flow already involving the client A project in Rike, and I'd like to duplicate this for the client B project. Simply selecting the ellipses here, I'll be able to see the duplicate option. As you can see, the block of work on the left stays the same, so that's my GitHub repository. And I'll be able to select the new Rike project or folder on the right-hand side. Here I'm going to pick the project for client B. From here, most information will copy over to the new flow, but we might want to change the rules slightly or tweak the mappings. In this example, I'm going to change the label trigger from client A to client B. And I'm going to also update the status trigger on the right side. For the field mappings, I'm going to leave them exactly the same. And that's it. Your flow is complete. Super easy. Once you've reviewed your flow, you can name it, then launch it, and move on to the next flow. As your workflow evolves, you might need to make refinements. If new fields or labels get added to your projects, or the rules that trigger cards and task desync change, or just internal changes in general, your flow might need to be edited. Editing your flow is super easy, and these changes can be applied retroactively. You can edit your flow by selecting the ellipses next to your flow here, or just simply selecting your flow like so. Let's say in our Airtable Trello flow, we want to change it to bi-directional because we want Airtable records to sync over into Trello. You can simply edit your flow direction here. We may also want to review the rules as well to see if we want to sync all Airtable records or just the subset. As you can see, I already have a trigger here where the team value in Airtable needs to be set to Trello in order for it to sync to Trello. When saving, we can choose to sync the historical Airtable records, meaning all those Airtable records will sync over to Trello, or choose to just sync newly created or modified records moving forward. Next up, we'll be diving deeper into more advanced rules and mappings to suit more complex workflows.